Welcome to Oracle Marketing Help Center videos. This video is the third in a series of others that looks to cover the marketing use cases of the Geofence and Beacon solution, how to implement it, and how marketers can maximize its potential. In this video, we'll go into more detail as to how exactly you can implement the solution. Let's walk through an example of how to work with the location provider. First, let's start in our location provider's app. For this example, we'll be using Blue Dot. We need to decide and configure our Geofences and Beacons. Our fictional store, Durham Denim, has a retail store located in Redwood City. We want to set up a geofence at this store, so when our mobile app users enter the vicinity of the store, they will be sent a push notification containing a personalized coupon to buy our merchandise. We won't go into too much detail on how to do this since your location provider may be different, but see their documentation on how to create and configure a geofence. What's important to note is that when defining your geofence or beacon, in order for our push notification to be personalized and contextually relevant, we'll need to define custom fields for our geofence. This adds more context to the geofence or beacon to make the event more actionable. It also enhances routing logic capabilities in programs, and ultimately, custom fields provide enhanced personalization. To make our coupon code personalized and contextually relevant, we'll need to define custom fields for our geofence. Here we're adding custom fields for the city, the store name, the applicable coupon code at the store, and the discount amount applicable at said store via the coupon code. That's the end of our geofence setup. Next, we'll need to create custom event fields in Responsys so that our custom fields can be sent and used in Responsys correctly. In Responsys, navigate to Tools, Events. There are four different types of location events. Select the drop-down menu on the event you want to edit and click Edit. Under Custom Variables, click the plus sign to add a custom variable for each custom field you define in the geofence. In this example, our data types are all text, but all data types are supported. The next few steps in this setup are specifically for mobile app developers. First, as a developer, you want to add the location provider's SDK to the mobile app. Next, update apps to use the latest Responsys mobile SDK. At minimum, the SDK should be at least version 19A or 6.40. Finally, develop the app layer code between the location provider's SDK and the Responsys SDKs. Refer to the mobile SDK documentation linked in the video description below for the sample code for Android and iOS where you can find details about each API. For each event, Oracle Responsys allows the app developer to pass optional key value pairs from the app using the event APIs. These key value pairs help marketers and app developers extend the functionality beyond the standard variables we described earlier. On the SDK side, each key value pair is passed as a string. Learn more about passing this optional data as part of the API calls in the documentation linked below. All of this data being described is also data that naturally must be retrieved from the location provider's SDK. The next video in this series will highlight the rest of the solution's design phase. Refer to the documentation on geofences and beacons provided in the video description below for more details. Thanks for watching and have a great day.